Welcome back, learners. I started making videos on cell biology, specifically on cell membrane structure. Honestly saying, I drifted away from continuing that series, but today I am suggesting you please watch that video that will make you understand today's video. We already learned about plasma membrane lipids, and in this video, we will get to know about the properties and functions of integral membrane protein, peripheral membrane protein, and lipid-anchored protein. Lipids are the fundamental structural elements of membranes. Proteins are responsible for carrying out specific membrane functions. Most plasma membrane consists of approximately 50% lipid and 50% of protein by weight, with the carbohydrate portion of glycolipids and glycoproteins constituting 5 to 10% of the membrane mass. Since proteins are much larger than lipids, there are many more lipid molecules than protein molecule. About 50 lipid molecules for one protein molecule. In this video, we already discussed Jonathan Singer and Garth Nicholson proposed the fluid mosaic model of membrane structure, which remains the basic paradigm for the organization of all biological membranes. Though plasma membrane is composed of several specialized domains, and about these domains we will get to know in our upcoming videos, but one of the central features of this fluid mosaic is they are inserted into the fluid bilayers. Both proteins and lipids are able to diffuse laterally through the membrane. This lateral movement of membrane proteins was first shown directly by Larry Fayo and Michael Edidin in 1970. Singer and Nicholson distinguished two classes of membrane-associated proteins, which they called peripheral and integral membrane proteins. Peripheral proteins were operationally defined as proteins that dissociate from the membrane following treatments with polar reagents, such as solution of extreme pH or high salt concentration that do not disrupt the phospholipid bilayer. Once dissociated from the membrane, peripheral membrane proteins are soluble in aqueous buffers. These proteins are not inserted into the hydrophobic interior of the lipid bilayer. Instead, they are indirectly associated with membranes through protein-protein interactions. These interactions frequently involve ionic bonds, which are disrupted by extreme pH or high salt. In contrast to the peripheral membrane proteins, integral membrane proteins can be released only by treatments that disrupt the phospholipid bilayer. Portions of these integral membrane proteins are inserted into the lipid bilayer, so they can be dissociated only by reagents that disrupt hydrophobic interaction. The most commonly used reagent for solubilization of integral membrane proteins are detergents, which are smaller amphipathic molecules containing both hydrophobic and hydrophilic groups. The hydrophobic portion of detergents displaces the membrane lipids and bind to the hydrophobic portions of integral membrane proteins. Because the other end of the detergent molecule is hydrophilic, the detergent protein complexes are soluble in aqueous solution. Many integral proteins are transmembrane proteins, which span the lipid bilayer with portions exposed on both sides of the membrane. These proteins can be visualized in electron micrographs of plasma membranes prepared by a freeze fracture technique. In these specimens, the membrane is split and separated into its two leaflets. Transmembrane proteins are then apparent as particles on the internal faces of the membrane. Most transmembrane proteins of the plasma membrane are glycoprotein with their oligosaccharides exposed on the surface of the cell. Studies of red blood cells have provided good example of both peripheral and integral proteins associated with the plasma membrane. The membranes of human erythrocytes contain about a dozen major proteins which were originally identified by gel electrophoresis of membrane preparations. The most abundant peripheral membrane proteins of red blood cell is pectin, which is a major cytoskeletal protein of erythrocytes. Other peripheral membrane proteins of red blood cells include actin and kyrin and BAN4.1. And kyrin serves as the principal link between the plasma membrane and cytoskeleton by binding to both spectrin and the integral membrane protein BAN3. The two major integral membrane proteins of red blood cells is glycoporin and BAN3 provides well-studied example of transmembrane protein structure. Let's learn about glycoporin here first. It is a small glycoprotein of 131 amino acids with molecular weight about 30,000 that crosses the membrane with a single membrane spanning alpha helix of 23 amino acids. It is heavily glycosylated, containing about 50% carbohydrate with the glycosylated amino terminal portion of the polypeptide chain exposed on the cell surface. The other major transmembrane protein of red blood cell is BAN3, and BAN3 is the amino transporter responsible for the passage of bicarbonate and chloride ion across the red blood cell membrane. The BAN3 polypeptide chain is 929 amino acid with 14 membrane spanning alpha helical regions. Within the membrane, dimers of BAN3 form globular structures containing internal channels through which ions are able to travel across the lipid bilayer. The first transmembrane protein to be analyzed by X-ray crystallography was the photosynthetic reaction center of the bacterium Rhodopseudomonas viridis. The reaction center contains three transmembrane proteins designated as L, M, and H. The light and medium subunits each have five membranes spanning alpha helices. The heavy subunit has only a single transmembrane alpha helix with the bulk of the polypeptide chain on the cytosolic side of the membrane. The fourth subunit of the reaction center is a cytochrome, which is a peripheral membrane protein bound to the complex by protein-protein interactions. In contrast to transmembrane proteins, a variety of proteins are anchored in the plasma membrane by covalently attached lipid or glycolipids. Members of one class of these proteins are inserted into the outer leaflet of the plasma membrane by glycosyl phosphatidyl inositol anchors. Some proteins are anchored in the outer leaflet of the plasma membrane by GPI anchors added to their C-terminus in the endoplasmic reticulum. These proteins are glycosylated and exposed on the cell surface. Other proteins are anchored in the inner leaflet of the plasma membrane following their translation on free cytosolic ribosomes. The SRC protein is anchored by a meristoyl group attached to its N-terminus. A positively charged region of SRC also plays a role in membrane association, perhaps interacting with the negatively charged head groups of phosphatidylserine. The RAS protein illustrated is anchored by a phenyl group attached to the side chain of a C-terminal cysteine. It is noteworthy that many of the proteins anchored in the inner leaflet of the plasma membrane play important roles in the transmission of signals from cell surface receptors to intracellular targets. This is all about today's video. I go through this book as a reference. Please read it for better insight. Please put a comment for any suggestion and queries regarding this much of this topic. Stay with us and thank you for your patience.